York right now in Grand Central. Just got off the train. Why is this not magnified? Hey guys, so this is the first stop of the journey. I just got on the train in Beacon in the Hudson Valley, upstate New York. It's about 80 minutes north of here. I'm now in Grand Central, about to make my way to John F. Kennedy Airport to get on a plane. Then I'm going over to LA, a few hours of a layover there, and then I get on the long journey to Sydney, which is about an 18-hour flight. So I'm feeling pretty prepared for that. I woke up early this morning just to make sure that I'm able to sort of get on the time zone and everything. Laptop, Kindle, everything's fully charged, so hopefully that goes okay. So now I'm gonna go and get to the airport, and then from there, just make some final phone calls, say some final goodbyes, and then it's see you later for 3.5 months. Walking down Lexington Avenue now, going to 53rd Street Station. I could have done this in the subway, but I decided that I was going to walk instead, just because I think this is gonna be the last chance I have to breathe saying fresh air in Manhattan. It's a bit ironic, but fresh air until I land in Sydney. So I'm gonna take advantage of that. Every time I say goodbye to my parents, even though I'm 31 years old, it's still a bit difficult. I know I live abroad in London, and I'm used to not being around them, but just saying goodbye to my mom and my dad there is a little bit tough before getting on the train. That the day is here with the trip starting. Something I've probably been wanting to do for a good 5 or 6 years. And for this specific trip, I started talking to my boss about it maybe about 6 or 7 months ago, and then got to the planning of it, I think started in early October. So it's been a long time coming, and I'm so excited, but at the same time, I don't know, it's that weird feeling where it kind of, I think it just doesn't really feel completely real yet that I'm gonna be going away. More than anything else for me, this is going away, pressing pause, trying to kind of refocus on the things that really matter to me. So we'll see how that goes. It could be a royal, an expensive failure. It could be great. Breaking a bit of a sweat here, which it's a bit strange in December in New York, but it's really warm right now. It's probably about 60 degrees, 15 Celsius. This is only the second time I've been holding a camera in public and talking to it, so it's still taking getting used to. Tried it in London, I got a lot of looks, but in New York I feel like everybody's in their own world and they've seen stranger things. I think I'm in one of those weird terminals in JFK, which doesn't have a food court or anything, so it might just be granola bars, but I'm gonna press on and see if there's anything else. I guess I've been away from New York long enough to be consistently shocked at the prices. This was $11 for essentially what is 2 slices of bread and a couple slices of turkey on it. So altogether, these 3 things were like $18. Crazy. This is what you get for $12 in New York. Ridiculous. So before I get going on this trip and start posting videos more frequently, I guess I just wanted to start and say why I'm doing it and what these videos are intended to be and what they're not intended to be. So the first thing is, I'm doing this for me. I'm doing this because I love to travel. I love to document my experiences. I have never been a huge fan of sharing on Facebook or things like that. The most that I do really is to post pictures every once in a while on Instagram. It's because I love it. I love photography. I love documenting interesting takes on places, people, and food that I experience, and that's really for me. But I guess the other part of that is a little bit different with this blog is that I work in an office. I've been working in an office job for 9 years. I love it, and I love what I do. But what I'm really passionate about is traveling, meeting people, visiting amazing places, just really being. Getting to see what everything that this world has to offer, and I mean that in a sincere sense. I would love to be able to, in someday, at some point in my life, actually step back from what I'm doing now, which again, I do love, but it's not necessarily my passion, and actually have a career that does reflect my passions. And I think to do that, you need to sort of hone your skills a little bit. You need to hone your voice. You need to hone your take on things and how you relate that to others. And so I'm hoping to get a little bit of editorial experience out of this. And hopefully as the videos go along, they get better. I'm starting from literally zero, so be forgiving at first. What this is to me as well is also a travel journal. This is a way for me to be able to kind of reflect and voice things that otherwise I wouldn't really be able to do because I'm doing most of this trip solo. So it's a way of me kind of playing back what I'm feeling and thinking, and I don't think that my intention with this trip is not to, you know, do one of those things where you go away and you find yourself and you come back a changed person or anything like that. I think there's two things that I'm doing with this trip. One is just experiencing the places that I'm visiting, which is completely separate, I see it, from the other part of this trip, which is, I think I've gotten really routine with a lot of things in my life and the sorts of people that I interact with, and I kind of want to, I love feeling challenged and meeting new people and being more open to strangers, and I kind of want to just go through that exercise and kind of do the things that I used to do more frequently. I guess the last thing to say is that having a vlog and posting these videos is, I was really excited about it a couple months ago, and now that it's actually happening and I'm doing it and I'm creating stuff, I have a little bit of trepidation, just because, you know, once stuff is out there, it is out there. I don't know any other way but to be completely transparent and honest and fully genuine with people in my life. And I think for me, I don't for a second want to have a persona or anything like that I don't share with you. You know, I open up more quickly than I would like to at times, but in this situation, I'm okay with that, and I'm not going to be anybody but me. That's I guess kind of a freeing place to be at, because I wasn't always like that, but it's also a little bit scary with posting videos online publicly. Probably a good time to tell you a little bit more about where I'm going to be going and why. And as I mentioned to you, I love traveling. I've done a lot of amazing trips, but mostly focused in Europe because I live in London, and there's so many amazing places that you can visit within 2.5 hours in London that literally costs you sometimes less than $150 for a return flight. So I've done a lot of that, gone to a lot of amazing places within Europe, mostly cities, some countries and regions, but I've only been to Asia twice, once to Thailand and once to Tokyo. And so for this trip, I really wanted to go to Asia and Australia and New Zealand as well, just because I think it's just such an incredible region. First of all, because there's so many different countries with so many amazing histories, cultures, but it's also really geographically diverse. So I'm gonna just get ready for my flight now, settle in by the gate, and then after that, it's off to LA. I got here about a couple hours ago. I'm just waiting for my flight to Sydney to be called, and then I'm off to Australia. This is gonna be the end of this video, so I'll see you when I'm in Oz.